stand in a white flat land, no shadow or shade of a doubt. Where the megaphone man met the girl with her hand that's covering most of her mouth. Fall in love with a bright idea and the way a world is revealed to you. Fat man and dancing girl, and most of the show is concealed from view. The monkey in the middle keeps doing that trick. It's making me nervous, get rid of it quick. MC on the stage tonight is a man named Billy Pearl. He's the international fun boy, and he knows the worth of a beautiful girl. Stand on the tightrope, never dream I could fall. Well, the monkey in the middle keeps doing that trick. It's making me nervous, get rid of it quick. I stand in a white flat land, no shadow or shade of a doubt. Where the megaphone man met the girl with her hand that's covering most of her mouth. Does she tell the truth? Does she hide the lie? Does she say it so no one can know? Fat man and dancing girl, and it's all part of the show, you know. Stand on the tightrope, never dream I could fall. Well, the monkey in the middle keeps doing that trick. It's making me nervous, get rid of it quick. The monkey in the middle keeps singing that tune. I don't want to hear it, get rid of it soon.
Thank you very much.
You, all this to say, what's it to you? Observe the blood, the rose tattoo of the fingerprints on me from you. Other evidence has shown that you and I are still alone. We skirt around the danger zone and don't talk about it, but Marlena watches from the wall. Her mocking smile says it all. She records the rise and fall of every soldier passing, but the only soldier now is me. Fighting things I cannot see. I think it's called life destiny that I am changing. Marlena on the wall. Well, I walk to your house in the afternoon, by the butcher shop with a sawdust room. Don't give away the goods too soon is what she might have told me. I tried so hard to resist when you held me in your handsome fist and reminded me of the night we kissed and of why I should believe. Marlena watches from the wall. Her mocking smile says it all. She records the rise and fall of every soldier passing, but the only soldier now is me. I'm fighting things I cannot see. I think it's called my destiny that I am changing. Marlena on the wall.
And even if I am in love with you. you. All this to say, what's it to you? Observe the blood, the rose tattoo of fingerprints on me from you. Other evidence has shown that you and I are still alone. We skirt around the danger zone, don't talk about it later. And I tried so hard to resist when you held me in your handsome fist and reminded me of the night we kissed and why I should believe. Marlena watches from the wall, her mocking smile says it all. She records the rise and fall of every man who's been here, but the only one here now is me, fighting things I cannot see. I think it's called my destiny, and I am changing, 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 changing. Marlena watches from the wall, her mocking smile says it all. She records the rise and fall of every soldier passing, but the only soldier now is me, fighting things I cannot see. I think it's called my destiny, and I am changing. Marlena on the wall. Much. How you doing? It's so exciting to be here, so close to New York City and out in the sunshine, and so thanks for having me. This is a song from the 99.9 Fahrenheit Degrees album, which is 25 years old this year. Thank you. Thank you. Let's go, Jerry. Slow and careful, settling the blame. I heard you say you look out for the feet of clay, that someone will be falling next without the chance. For last respect, you feel the disappointment. When heroes go down, man or woman reveal, you can't expect any kind of mercy on the battlefield. Say you look out for the feet of clay, that someone will be falling next without the chance. For last respect, you feel the disappointment. When heroes go down, man or woman reveal, do you show any kind of mercy on the battlefield? When heroes go down, when heroes go down, do another song from that album. This is a song that was a number one alternative hit in 1992. I hope you like it. It's called Blood Makes Noise. Yes, I really, really would. But the dead in my head, it's too much and it's no good. I'm standing in a windy tunnel, shouting through the roar, and I'd like to give the information asking for. But blood makes noise. It's a ringing in my ear. Blood makes noise. I can't really hear you in the thick of my fear. to know the details and the facts, but there's something in my blood denies the memory of the act. So just forget it, Doc. I think it's really cool that you're concerned. We'll have to try again after the silence has returned, 'cause blood makes noise. It's a ringing in my ear, blood makes noise. I can't really hear you in the thickening of fear. Yes, I really, really would, but the dead in my head, it's too much and it's no good. Blood makes noise. It's ringing in my ear. Can't really hear you in the thickening of fear. Yes, blood makes noise. It's a ringing in my ear. Can't really hear you in the thickening of fear.
On guitar. Thank you. Well, that's enough nostalgia. I think I'd like to do some new songs now. These are some songs from a play that I wrote. The album is called Lover Beloved, Songs from an Evening with Carson McCullers. Carson McCullers is a great American writer. Her first book came out in 1940. And this song is called Carson's Blues, and it gives you a little taste of what her character was like. This is a play that I wrote. All right, ready?
A fallen deer, that's what they call me, but I'm an iron butterfly. A childish liar, a devilish bitch. I can be innocent and charming and suddenly switch, but you've got to understand that I've never belonged. I can be sweet, I can be wise, and I've got every one of you mirrored in my deep, sad eyes. I know where you've been to and who you're afraid to be, 'cause nothing that is human is alien to me. I talk to strangers, 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 one at a time.
Red sparrow, timid and shy. A fallen deer, that's what they call me, but I'm an iron butterfly. I know where you've been to and who you're afraid to be. 'Cause nothing that is human is alien to me. I talk to strangers, strangers, strangers. One at a time. Thank you very much. Thanks. So Carson McCullers came from the deep south. She came from Columbus, Georgia. And her dream was to come to New York City and live. And that's exactly what she did. And this song is called New York is My Destination. And it has her dreams, her fantasies, and then a few things that actually happened. Destination. New York is where I will be from. New York is made for grander things just like me. I will lunch at the Algonquin, swing by the Plaza, waltz on in the Three Arts Club. I'll live there indefinitely. 'Cause New York is made for grander things just like me. Literati, yes, they will love me. Paparazzi, well, could this be? Glitterati, well, they know of me. New York's waiting for me. All of the tales of seduction, glitter and snow, finally. 'Cause New York is made for grander things just like me. Literati, yes, they will love me. Paparazzi, well, could this be? Glitterati, well, they know of me. New York's waiting for me. New buses weave some tale about us. I lost all my money for Juilliard. I hid in the phone booth at Macy's. I slept in a brothel on the way to my destiny. 'Cause New York is made for grander things just like me. Literati, yes, they will love me. Paparazzi, well, could this be? Glitterati, they know of me. New York's waiting for me. New York is made for grander things just like me. Thank you. Thanks. So Carson McCullers wrote a book called The Member of the Wedding. And it's a story about a young girl, she's 12 years old, whose brother is getting married. And she's sad because she loves her brother, but she's happy because he's happy. But she's feeling alone and she decides one day she's gonna join the wedding. Now think about that. She joins not only the wedding, but the marriage. And it does not end very happily. But this song takes place at that part in the book. It's called The We of Me. Just as she's figured out this great answer. One, two, three, four, five. there's one more that could be long. This must be the irony of fate. I and the world are always separate. All other people have a we to claim, except for me and my own name. I belong to be with the two of you, and we make three as a family. Thank you. We'll do one more song from the play. This is a song called Harper Lee. Now, Harper Lee was also a writer, and she wrote a very famous book called To Kill a Mockingbird. It came out 20 years after Carson McCullough's big famous novel, The Heart is a Lonely Hunter. Yes, thank you. So when To Kill a Mockingbird came out, Carson McCullers had a few jealous feelings because she had already been there and done that. But it turns out, not only jealous feelings about Harper Lee, but about all the other writers of her generation. Do you guys like to read? Like reading? Great. So she had a lot of feelings, and there were a lot of writers, and so we go into a lot of detail in this song. Virginia Woolf, she leaves me cold. I recognize the genius, but I'm twice as bold. I have more to say than Hemingway. Lord knows, compared to Faulkner, I say it in a better way. Graham Greene, he loves me. He loves my poetic sensibility. Catherine Ann Porter might be the best one now, but in about a year, I'm gonna show her how. Yes, I will. I said to Reeves the other day, Proust really is the man who comforts me in a way no other writer can. The timeless quality of the work, the length is very long. Believe me, Marcel Proust goes on and on and on and on for 7 volumes. Now Harper, Harper, Lee, 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 she only wrote the one book. I've written more than 3. Darling Tennessee Williams, it's anybody's guess why Streetcar made millions and Wedding so much less. I will forever be pondering that one. Thank you. out, Eudora Welty. As for F. Scott, my sad cafe is greater than his Gatsby. I'm just telling you what someone told me they read, 'cause I never look at my reviews, they might give me the big head. Now Truman Capote was hypnotized, mesmerized, 'cause he realized that I knew that he knew that he had plagiarized my cadences. Imagine his surprise, you'll see it in his eyes when I win that Nobel Prize. Thank you so much. I shall be humble yet gracious. She's poaching on my literary preserves. Yes, from Harper Lee we have seen and we've heard, and I'd like to kill more than just that mockingbird. You know, sometimes I really would. So you just wait until next year. Thank you very much. The play's gonna have its world premiere in Houston, Texas on Valentine's Day of next year. So if you're in Houston, Texas, Valentine's Day, swing on by. Thank you. Right. Here's one you might know. If you want, you can find me left of center off of the strip, in the outskirts, in the fringes, in the corner out of the grip. If you want me, you can find me left of center off of the strip, in the outskirts, in the fringes, in the corner out of the grip. When they ask me, what are you looking at? I always answer, nothing much, not much. They know that I'm looking at them. Think they think I must be out of touch, but I'm only in the outskirts, in the fringes, on the edge of the avenue. And if you want me, you can find me left of center. Somewhere inside of us, we must be similar, if not the same. So I continue to be wanting you left of center against the grain. If you want me, you can find me left of center off of the strip, in the outskirts, in the fringes, in the corner, out of the grip. Out of touch, but I'm only in the outskirts, in the fringes, on the edge and off the avenue. And if you want me, you can find me left of center, wondering about you. Wondering about you. Wondering about you. Thank you very much. going to do another newish song, and this one is called I Never Wear White. Because my color is black. So the song sort of explains why I never wear white and why my color is black. You can wear whatever you like, but that's the way it is for me, so. Yes, it is. But even in New York, I get people like, where's the funeral? And that kind of thing. You know what I'm saying? So I thought, well, I'll write it all out.
If we had
vacant room where people do not stay. And shadows touch and pass right through and never see the day. Secret self and disappeared like the snow. I could have played your little girl, or I could have played your wife, I could have played your mistress, running like the foam from the sea. I could have been your woman of the road as long as you did not come back home to me. But as it is, we live in the city. Everything stays in place. Instead sidewalk, and it's well I know your face. Talk and talk, we tell the truth. There are no shadows here. When I look into your eyes, I wonder what might happen here. If I had met you on some journey, Jerry Leonard on guitar. Yuval Lion on drums. George Farmer on bass. Alex Hugg on sound. And everything else, actually. So thanks so much for coming out. Join my Facebook page if you're not there already. Ooh, that's beautiful. So, as I said, join my Facebook page. That's how you know about new CDs, the play, other stuff. You get pictures of what we're eating on tour. Very exciting. You get to see pictures of my dog. And you get to celebrate my birthday, which is next Tuesday, online with me. So thank you so much for having me. You've been great. Mwah, thanks.
I think you've seen me before. If you hear something late at night, some
pull some kind of fight. Just don't ask me what it was. Just don't ask me what it was. Just don't ask me what it was. I think it's 'cause I'm clumsy. I try not to talk too loud. Maybe it's because I'm crazy. I try not to act too proud. And then only hit until you cry. After that, you don't ask why. You just don't argue anymore. You just don't argue anymore. You just don't argue anymore. Yes, I think I'm okay. I walked into the door again. Well, if you ask, that's what I'll say. It's not your business anyway. I guess I'd like to be alone. Nothing broken, nothing thrown. Just don't ask me how I am. Just don't ask me how I am. Just don't ask me how I am. My name is Luca. I live on the second floor. I live upstairs from you. Yes, I think you've seen me before. If you hear something late at night, some kind of trouble, some kind of fight, just don't ask me what it was. Just don't ask me what it was. Just don't ask me what it was. May only hit until you cry. After that, you don't ask why. You just don't argue anymore. Just don't argue anymore. Just don't argue anymore. Thank you. Thank you very much. Are you ready? For coffee? At Tom's Diner.
Her umbrella, and I look the other way as they are kissing their hello.
died while he was drinking. It was no one I had heard of. And I'm turning to the horoscope and looking for the funnies when I'm feeling someone watching me. And so low is my head. She does not really see me, cause she sees her own reflection. And I'm trying not to notice that she's cinching up her skirt, and while she's straightening her stockings, her hair is gotten wet.
Thank you.